is my ass getting hot right now?
It's over. Pizza week is over. What up? It's the trooper. Shout out to Harry. You know who Harry is? You know Harry. Harry from the vlog. Yo, Harry just got married to his new wife, Candace, on September 1st. Can you believe that? This past Saturday, Harry gets hitched, and now he's in Europe on his honeymoon. He sent me a picture from Switzerland last night. I'm a little jealous. Yeah, but anyway, yo, shout out to Harry, congratulations, and, you know, yo, ha, what am I saying? I don't know, let's go. Ha, that, all that shit rhymes. Yo, here's something funny. When I was editing the vlog from yesterday, the Pizza Rock pizza, I was this close to wanting pizza. Like, no, I wanted it. I was like, you know what? I'm gonna go back to Pizza Rock today because that shit was so good. But yo, man, that was the 8th day in a row that I had pizza. Pizza week is done, over and done with. You hear what I'm saying to you? Ha! You can see nobody there. Yo, it's over with. I gotta take a little break on the pizza. I mean, it was fun and it was good and we got a lot of great pizza from Vegas, but yo, it's over. So today, I'm gonna go with something a little more healthy, I guess. I don't know if it's more healthy or not, but I'm gonna go to Teriyaki Madness because I want that salmon bowl. Let's eat some fish and vegetables, a little bit of rice, and yeah. You know, if I eat fish and vegetables, I gotta show you or you will never believe it. All right, I got some iced coffee going for the drive. And now, there's someone downtown that wants a hat. So, I'm gonna head back downtown, deliver this hat, and then I'm gonna figure out where to play poker. I think I have an idea where I wanna play, but I'm not 100% sure yet. This traffic is a bitch today. Why would you be getting over, you face? Going slower than everyone else, you dumb. The close of pizza week has left a hole in my heart. Actually, it might be a blockage, but you know what I'm trying to say. Like, I feel a little lost. I'm not going to have pizza right now. You know, and it's like I'm calling the girl after she broke away. I'm calling her, and then when she answers, I hang up. Like one of the, no, I never did that, but I'm just saying, like, you know what I mean? You fucking dick. You're not gonna believe this, but I'm like, why is my ass getting hot right now? Like, what's going on? And then I look down, I turn the friggin' seat warmers on high. It's got three levels, like low, medium, and high. I had that shit on high. My ass is on fire right now. I feel like I'm sitting on a burner. This shit is crazy. Sick and tired. I'm so sick and tired. It's Jeff and
Stacy,
and from Gabby,
Ohio,
and Zoe.
Is that right? Ohio,
Indiana,
close enough.
Somewhere in the middle,
somewhere
Midwest.
Yo, the first time I met Jeff, I was dealing at the Link, and he came through. All right, let's not get killed. Let's make our way back to the Trooper Mobile and find a poker game. I guess that's what we do, right? Yo, if you come to Vegas and you misbehave, you'll find yourself over here. The detention center. Clark County Detention Center. That's where to take your ass to jail at right there.
Yo, believe it or not, I've been craving some off-strip action. So I'm gonna go to Red Rock. I just double checked, it is Tuesday. It's Tuesday and I just double checked and they do have their quad flopper promotion still going. So on Tuesdays, if you flop quads with a pocket pair, you get $500. Let's always keep in mind that when I say things like what I just said, I'm not thinking about flopping quads. I'm thinking about all the people who are trying to flop quads. That's what makes the game good. By the way, when I just looked at Bravo, I just noticed something. Red Rock now has a good beat jackpot. You heard me right. A good beat jackpot. So in other words, it's a bad beat, but the winning hand gets the biggest portion rather than the losing hand getting the biggest portion. So you want to be the winner of the bad beat jackpot. That's an interesting concept. I don't think I've ever heard of that before. I don't know if they made it up. Maybe it's ever happened at some place before. Who knows? Let me know in the comments below if you know about that, because I'm interested in that. Yo, let's go to Red Rock, play some poker, and yeah! Ever okay, but this time you're wrong. We need this chance, so come get me some. Remember the day was the storm of hell, you were from away. Remember, you said that you'll never let me fall down again. I'm so sick and tired. I'm so sick and tired. I'm so sick and tired, but I still wanna be. All right, Red Rock it is. I forgot to mention that the Good Beat jackpot is a one table, it's like a single table payout, so it's not everyone in the room. The total is $6,000, $500 is added weekly, and it's the winner of the hand gets 40%, the loser gets 20%, and then 40% gets divided amongst the table. Interesting. And oh yeah, it's aces full of tens or better, beaten by quads or better. Was trying to be a good game, and then it was kind of crippled for a few minutes, and now it's trying to be a good game again. Had to get a little coffee action going, but I've got a sort of like a not a question, but well, maybe it's a question. It's a question to find out the opinion of others. Might be too dark out here. Can you see me? Can you see me? So here's the question. So this is a question for people who are either really good dealers or who are supervisors or tournament directors who are experienced and who know poker, who really know poker. So I've thought about this in the past, but it sort of came up earlier. It didn't come up as an issue for anyone else, only in my own head. But think about this for a second. So a guy makes it 25, right? So when it goes to the next guy, you know what a string bet is, right? So a string bet, so first of all, this is kind of weird. Why is there smoke coming out of the lights down here? I don't know if you can see it or not. Look at this, there's smoke coming out of it. Coming out of two of them, but it's not coming out of the others. I think that might be dangerous or something. So you know what a string bet is. So if a guy doesn't say anything and he grabs five red chips and puts them across the line and goes back and grabs five more red chips and put them across the line, that is not going to be a standing bet or raise. That's a string bet. So he's gonna be bound to just calling the 25. But if a guy pushes out $40 without saying anything, he's put out an amount that is the original bet plus at least half or more than half of
the original bet. Because half of the bet would be $12.50. He put out the bet plus 15, which is 40. Now, in this situation, if he pushes that out without saying anything, that is a raise to 50, and he has to bring it up to $50. He has to put 10 more dollars in the pot. All right, we understand this. So now if a guy says 75, before he does anything, he just says 75. Or raise 50 more, or something like that, then he is bound to doing what he verbalized. So here's an interesting situation. What if the guy grabs $40 in red chips, puts it across the line, breaks it down into a second stack, and then says 75? Is that a string bet? Since when he first went out, he only had 40 in his hand. You can't go back, so how can you go back verbally? Now, by the way, this is not what happened earlier. What happened earlier is the guy grabbed $40, pushed it out, broke it into two stacks, and said 50. Turns out that if he had just let go of the chips, he would be bound to 50 anyway, right? Because of the example I just said. But I find it interesting that someone could... I mean, those are weird numbers. A more common occurrence would be a situation where, you know, I mean, to make it a little more realistic, a guy pushes out, 50, and then a guy grabs, you know, $80 in chips, pushes it over the line, begins to break it down, and says 160 or something like that. Like, in my opinion, that would be a verbal string bet. Tell me what you think, because basically you can only go out one time unless you verbalize before you make your bet. But what about verbalizing after you've already crossed the line with some money? So anyway, I don't know. It's just a question for you. I'm going to ask some people who really know poker around here and see what they think. I know what you're thinking, Trooper. Why you got a stank face on? Well, because the new phone streak is over. I had 9 winners in a row. 9! 9 winning sessions in a row. 9 green numbers. I think one was like $13. But 9 green numbers in a row. And then today broke it. And you think to yourself, like, it's never gonna break. Like, I'm just gonna win every day. But you know that's not possible. It has to break at some point. I don't know what my record is for winning days in a row or like not losers. It's really a stupid number though, like a stupid thing to think about. Oh, how many days I won in a row? Because it can be rigged. I don't know where I parked. Damn, it smells like cotton candy and ass in here. Because it can be rigged. Like, you can walk into the casino and sit down and win your first pot and leave. You're like, oh, another winner in a row. The point is that it's pointless to keep track of that. It was fun having 9 winners in a row, but tonight I lost how much did I lose? 139. 139. Most of the entire session, I got no cards and no situations. And my game was like kind of so-so, and then it went to really bad, and then it went to kind of so-so again. There was like, oh, we're all really impressed. Super impressed. Like you built the car from scratch. There was one semi-maniacal player in the game. It was like he wanted to be a maniac, but didn't really have the balls to be a true maniac or something. Like, it was kind of weird because he wouldn't rebuy, but he would like bet blind occasionally and get it all in like kind of crazy.
on occasion, I don't know, it's kind of hard to explain, but once he left the game, it was like, I looked around and I'm like, why am I gonna stay in this game? So that was it. Yo, remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. You almost see you next time.